I'm assuming you asked because he died today. Other than some halaqat that he gave in the Haram al-Makki, when I went to perform Umrah, I never studied under him. But I also used to listen to him a lot on a radio program back in the day called Nuran ala Darb, a very famous and popular question and answer. However, one thing about him that I remember, and I remember almost every time he's mentioned, is that when I was in Medina and Salih al-Haydan was clearly rising back then in prominence and in ranks, a sheikh I visited told me, do you know the major factor in his rise? And I said, how? He said, the previous mufti, Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Sheikh rahimahullah ta'ala, who was the mufti prior to Ibn Baz. And by the way, Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Sheikh rahimahullah ta'ala was praised by Sheikh Nasr. I heard him and he told me about him. And he said that his father, Sheikh Nasr, fakallahu asra, his father, rahimahullah ta'ala, worked for him and knew him closely. And they knew some of his positions and opinions on matters. Now, Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Sheikh, rahimahullah ta'ala, chose Salih al-Haydan, young Salih al-Haydan back then, from among those surrounding him, to be his first and main secretary and companion who did nearly everything for him. And the main reason, supposedly, for choosing him was because he would keep any orders and discussions and conversations totally confidential, even if they were not private and even if he was not told to keep them private. So the Mufti trusted him and brought him closer than his own sons and took him as close as his own sons. And that's where his career took off from. If you have someone around you who consistently can't hold water, it's a good idea to distance yourself, because loose lips sink ships.